Okay, social media. Today we'll be talking about four aspects you've possibly never thought about social medias and that can completely change the response you get as an artist or as a teacher in your social media marketing plan. This is The Music of Tomorrow. My name is Ian Ruas, and in this channel, I teach digital marketing and content strategies for musicians. And you're gonna tell me, but Ian, social media marketing plan, I don't even know what to do with the social media marketing plan. And I'm gonna tell you, but after today, you will. Social media is a reality. And if you ignore this fact, you're gonna end up obsolete and your message as an artist will never be heard, or not as much as it could. So let me start by saying that I personally advocate for live experience. There is no substitute for the energy of physical connections. And I believe a strong online presence can amplify these moments rather than taking away from them. What I mean by that is that I think many times people take live performances as granted. They think it's expensive, they don't want to pay for it, which might end up becoming a commodity and losing its value. With the ascension of the social medias, we'll be able to promote our music, our art, and use marketing strategies to create expectation about our concerts, which will make it increasing value. So now I'm gonna break the subject into four topics and tell you how I look at social medias and what I think you should do to optimize your chances to be seen, admired, and build a fan base of loyal fans and students. Topic number one, social medias are like parties. Internet interaction is just a reflection of our own lives' interaction. And I think a lot of people don't think about that. But think about it for a second. As a society, we are able to understand if certain attitudes are appropriate or inappropriate. And on the internet, we can as well. So in the world of the internet, I see social media as a party where people go to have fun, connect, and exchange some information. It would be appropriate to see people talking, interacting, telling jokes, exchanging information, music going on, maybe someone doing a magic trick in a party, right? Now, what wouldn't be appropriate in a party / social media? Maybe if you're approached by someone trying to sell you their watch. Yo, you wanna buy my watch? I sell it to you really, really cheap. Or, hey, I'm a math teacher, do you wanna hire me? This would probably seem a little weird, right? Or someone giving out flyers of their next concerts, right? Right? The same applies to social media. If you look like a salesman desperate to sell your art in that environment that is made for social interaction, you'll probably get little to no interest in your posts. Instead, you should try to fill in with that criteria of information, entertainment, and connection. And if you saw some of my other videos, that's what I mean by value. If you are delivering either information, entertainment, or connection, you're actually delivering appropriate value to people. They will feel comfortable in interacting with these types of things. So a practical example would be if you're a music teacher who wants to advertise your online course. Instead of posting, hey people, I'm teaching private lessons, inbox me for more info, try posting a video of yourself playing something really cool and then teaching how to do it to really benefit the student and leave them with a feeling like, I wish I could learn more from this person. This way you are nurturing that student to keep following you and eventually really craving to learn from you. Then every once in a while, you can make an offer to something that you are selling, but only when you are already delivering real value. That's an example of giving information, which is one of the appropriate things I mentioned to do in a social media. And as an artist, instead of posting a flyer of your next show and buy your ticket now, try posting a really cool performance video and remind your audience that you'll be live at a certain day. That way you're actually delivering entertainment to your audience instead of selling them something. And as far as connection, you could post inspirational videos or pictures or phrases that will actually touch people's emotions and will make them connect with you. Okay, topic number two, don't confuse your audience. Imagine if you went to an ice cream shop that you really, really love. And you've been there many times. But this time, they were only selling chicken noodles. The same store, same owner, same place. You'd be like, what's going on? You guys don't serve ice cream anymore? Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't, it depends. What do you mean, it depends? That's kind of crazy, right? You only go there for the damn ice cream. Well, this is the same that happens to your audience on social media. If you have pictures of your dog, your family, the sunset, the food that you ate last night in your music, your audience will never see consistency in your content and won't come back. This is really important, guys. Your social media is a place to be very, very, very specific. Even within music, you need to be specific about the style, the look of the page, the mood. So once your audience, who already have been there and shown interest in your music, when they go back there, they will feel like they're getting what they're looking for. And if you want to keep your account for personal stuff, you can. But make sure you create an appropriate separate space, aka social media account, for your music or for your music lessons. Topic number three, be omnipresent. Imagine for a second if you managed to save $1 million out of general savings, royalties for your music, etc. This is all the money you have right now. Not bad, right? So you decide to invest all this money in the stock market at a rate of approximately 7% a year, let's say. That's 70 grand that you'll be earning every year just to leave you there. Okay, but in the next day, something happens, like a global pandemic. You might be familiar with the topic. And the market that you invested all of your money in lost all its value. In other words, you lost all of your money that you were able to save with years of hard work. That's heartbreaking, right? Well, when you're building your career on a social media, you have a similar risk. Social medias are private companies and anything can happen to them at any time. They can be sold, lose their popularity, or change their policy. In fact, just recently, Facebook changed its policy and it affected millions of business and artists. This is our topic number four. Find a more reliable source. So a few years ago, Facebook, which owns Instagram, changed their distribution policies and it impacted everyone who was using these platforms. Maybe you have noticed that now when you post something, it seems like only a very small percentage of your followers engage with it, meaning like it or comment or share it. That's not because your friends and fans don't want to support you, but because not all of them have access to your post. They never get to see it. And this is because Facebook started charging for paid advertisement. So what they do is they restrict the distribution of your organic posts, aka free posts, to push you into paying for advertisement, which might not be a bad idea for you if you know how to do it effectively. But we'll talk more about that in an upcoming video. For now, I would recommend that you don't pay for advertisement unless you really know what you're doing. So the first thing I would say to try and diminish this risk is to be present in more than one social media. Grow an audience in the most popular ones by having your posts in all of them. And if you're wondering how you're gonna manage to have time for all of this, there is a system to optimize the same posts so they can be effectively distributed in different platforms. I'm also gonna talk about that in an upcoming video. And then the other reason why it might be cool to be in different platforms is that your audience uses different platforms, so you make it easier for them to find you wherever they are. And the second thing is to find a more reliable source. And what do I mean by that? You need to have a place in which you have direct contact with your audience, a place where you make sure everyone will get your content, your new releases, and your concert information. And the best place I find to do that is an email list. An email is yours. Most of us have had the same email address forever. And even if you happen to change emails, you can export and import your contact list. So if all social medias go down at the same time, your career doesn't go down with it. But as I spoke in the last video, make sure you build this email list out of fans who voluntarily subscribe to it. So you gotta offer them something cool through your social medias and request their email if they want to access or information about your offer. Don't go out spamming everyone. Don't do that. But an email list is not the only reliable source. I've seen people creating communities and even using Telegram to gather their fans. So I hope you enjoyed this content. If you found this helpful, subscribe to our channel in the button below so we can keep in touch and you can have access to our upcoming videos. Hoping you are all safe out there. Have a great week. See you in the next video.